Victor was born to Kram and his wife. Between May and August 1976, Victor Kram was thin, dark and sallow-skinned with a large curved nose and thick black eyebrows. He grew up in Bulgaria and attended the Durmstrang Institute. He was one of the last people to purchase a wand from Grigorovich before his retirement. The wand was made of hornbeam wood with a dragonhair string core. During his time at school, Victor was confronted by what he believed to be the symbol of Gellert Grindelwald, which was indeed the symbol of the Deathly Hallows that have been carved into the walls by the wizard himself. Although students at the school began copying the symbol onto their books and clothing as a way of trying to shock and impress, he was highly insulted since his grandfather had been murdered by Grindelwald. Victor and several other students who had also lost family at the hands of the Dark Wizard taught them the error of their ways. The 1994 Quidditch World Cup. As a skilled Quidditch seeker, Victor was selected to play for the Bulgarian national Quidditch team, despite still being at school, and was widely regarded as one of the best players in the world. In 1994, he played in the Quidditch World Cup and helped Bulgaria reach the final against the Irish national Quidditch team. He was considered a fantastical, exciting player to watch, so much that even some of those who were supporting Ireland couldn't help but cheer for him. He's unbelievable, he's really young too, only just 18 or something, he's a genius. You wait until tonight, you'll see. During the final match, Victor fooled the Irish seeker Aidan Lynch by performing a runski feint that resulted in Lynch falling into the ground. Despite his skills, the Irish side were too good for the Bulgarians, and Victor decided to end the match by catching the golden snitch. During his pursuit of the snitch, he was hit in the face by a bludger, which broke his nose and gave him two black eyes. However, he caught the snitch and ended up the match on his own terms. Harry had never seen anyone fly like that. Kram hardly looked as though he was using a broomstick at all. He moved so easily through the air that he looked unsupported and weightless. In the same year, Victor was part of the Durmstrang delegation that travelled with Igor Kakarov to Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry to compete in the Triwizard Tournament on the 30 October. His presence at the school caused a stir amongst the students' bodies since he was famous and he was constantly followed by a group of girls. One of the few exceptions to this was Hermione Granger. Victor entered his name into the Goblet of Fire to participate in the tournament. He most likely did this in order to gain eternal glory and to make his school proud. He was selected as the Durmstrang champion during the Halloween feast on 31 October. He expressed no opinion on the entry of a fourth champion, Harry Potter, into the tournament when he found out. It seems as though he viewed Harry as just another champion of the tournament. Before the start of the tournament, Victor took part in the Wand Weave ceremony overseen by Garrick Ollivander and had only a small mention in Rita Skeeter's article on the tournament. Skeeter's article focused on Harry Potter's interests, and Victor was only mentioned in the last line of the article. Even then, his name was misspelled. Victor spent a lot of time at Hogwarts in the library, as he had become attracted to Hermione Granger. Each day he went to the library with the intention to talk to her, but could not work up the courage. The groups of girls continued to follow him, stuck behind bookcases and watching him. On 24 November, Victor took part in the first test of the Triwizard Tournament. He had been told about the dragons by Kakarov, who had sneaked into the Forbidden Forest, and showed no surprise when the dragon test was announced. He drew the Chinese Fireball and the number 3 slot. Entering the arena after Flor Delacour, Victor didn't even think of flying. He used the conjunctivitis curse to blind the dragon and retrieve the golden egg, but the dragon, confused and blinded, stomped around and crushed half the real eggs it was guarding. Victor lost points for that and tied with Harry Potter for first place. With approach of the yellow ball, Victor finally found the courage to ask Hermione to the ball. Even though he could barely pronounce her name, they with the other champions opened the dancing at the ball. Hermione spent the evening trying to teach Victor how to pronounce her name correctly, but did not succeed. They also spent much of the evening dancing with one another, an unexpected side effect of their apparent relationship, that Hermione was chosen by the judges of the tournament to be the hostage that Victor would have to rescue from the Black Lake. Having worked up the clue from the golden egg, Victor knew he had to breathe underwater for at least 1 hour during the second test. It is unknown if he worked the clue out on his own or he had help from the Durmstrang headmaster. He chose to attempt to transfigure himself into a shark but managed only to transfigure his head. Still, it worked well enough for him to reach the Merope village. However, the teeth on his shark head were not placed well enough to bite through the ropes holding Hermione. Harry, who had reached the village before Victor, saw the trouble he was having and feared for his friend. He grabbed a rock, then thumped Victor on the shoulder and gave it to him. Taking the rock, Victor cut through the ropes holding Hermione and headed for the surface. He arrived outside the time limit in second place, but was awarded third place after the judge took into account Harry's determination to rescue all the hostages. Back on dry land, Victor confessed to Hermione that he had never felt about a girl the way he felt about her, and invited her to stay with him in Bulgaria over the summer. Before the third disc, Victor viewed the beginnings of the maze that he would have to navigate. On their way back to the castle, Victor took Harry to one side to ask him about his relationship with Hermione. Following the second disc, Rita Skeeter had written an article concerning Hermione toying with Harry and Victor's affections. Victor searched for Harry and questioned him about the article. Harry assured Victor that he and Hermione were only friends, but their conversation was started by the arrival of a confused party Crouch Sr. While Harry rushed to get help, Victor remained with Crouch. Victor entered the maze behind Harry and Cedric and began searching for the Triwizard Cup. During the task, Party Crouch Jr., posing as Alastair Moody by the way of Polyjuice Potion, managed to place the Imperious Curse on Victor as part of his plot to steer Harry Potter to victory in the tournament. Under Moody's control, he caught up with Cedric and performed the Cruciatus Curse on him. However, he was stunned by Harry and left unconscious. Cedric, against his better judgment, used his wand to shoot red sparks into the ear, allowing him to be rescued from the maze. Following the tournament and the murder of Cedric Diggory, Victor was revived by Albus Dumbledore when he was stunned by Party Crouch Jr. Victor attended the Leaving Feast, which was also a memorial service for Cedric. Victor left Hogwarts on the next day, saying a private goodbye to Hermione, giving Ron his autograph and expressing to Harry his regret over the death of Cedric. After the Triwizard Tournament, despite his offer, Hermione never visited Victor in Bulgaria, but the two continued to correspond through letters. Victor Crumb appeared on a chocolate frog cart during the 1996-1997 school year. On 1st August 1997, Victor attended the wedding of Lord Delacour and Bill Weasley at Flor's invitation. He noticed that Xenophilius Lovegood was wearing the same mold that had come to be associated with the Dark Wizard Gellert Grindelwald. In conversation with Harry Potter, who was discussed by Polyjuice Potion and going under the name of Barney Weasley, he expressed the desire to duel him for wearing the symbol, but held back because it was Flor's wedding. Barney attempted to assure him that Xenophilius probably thought it meant something beyond what Crumb associated with. While at the reception, Victor greeted Hermione excitedly, commenting that she looked wonderful. Ron Weasley quickly pulled her to the dance floor with him, and Victor was disappointed to learn that the two were on a romantic relationship. He then commented to and discussed Harry that Ginny Weasley was very pretty. Harry immediately told him Ginny was seeing someone who was big and the jealous type, and that Victor would not want to cross him. Victor then claimed the fact, "What is the point of being an international Quidditch player if all good-looking girls are taken?" Being a young man of great strength of character, as well as his loyalties as a friend of Hermione, it is likely he helped the members of the Order of the Phoenix protect the attendants of the wedding from the attacking Death Eaters. However, as Remus Lupin confirmed that no one had been killed, it is unlikely Crumb suffered any great injuries during if he did participate in it. Later life, Crumb continued his Quidditch career, representing Bulgaria in international Quidditch match until 2002. However, Crumb's ambition to help Bulgaria win the Quidditch World Cup made him come out of retirement to compete in 2014 Quidditch World Cup. At 38 years old, Crumb was old for a seeker, but he ended up catching the snitch and secured Bulgaria's victory over Brazil in the World Cup final. Bulgaria's success was described by Ginny Potter as being mostly due to Victor Crumb's excellent performance. Victor eventually found love with someone from his native Bulgaria. He also kept in contact with Hermione, although the relationship was nothing more than friends.